The next part just talks about 1.5.1 computer-aided design. And I don't know if you've heard about 3D printing recently. So 3D printing is taking off. Now, what we're talking about is, as we go forward, more and more sort of manufacturing is becoming robotic. Okay? But the thing is, it's not just about having a robot. So for example, if you go to a car plant, you have this robot that, and its job is only to bolt doors onto the car. Now we're talking about this product being designed from concept, right, to finish, solely with computer-aided design, okay? The last big example of this was the, I don't know if you're familiar with planes, but the Boeing 777 Dreamliner. This was a plane that, normally when they build a plane, they build a prototype, they put it in a wind tunnel, and they see how it reacts. This plane never went through all of that. This plane, the whole thing was done into the computer-aided design and computer simulation. More interestingly, because Boeing used computerized software to do this, they outsourced manufacturing to 11 countries. So for example, the right wing was built in Japan, the left wing was built in Italy, and the batteries for the plane came in India. And the plane was just assembled in Seattle, which was Boeing's main manufacturing plant. Okay? Obviously, that has issues later on, and we'll talk about that in chapter 2. The next part of it is computer-aided manufacturing. And from a computer-aided manufacturing point of view, this has been around for ages. It's just we'll be talking about robotics enabling certain sort of redundant tasks that are not suitable for human beings to do. You know, things that are sort of routine, daily, stuff that you're doing over and over again. In any case, you put computer-aided designing and computer-aided manufacturing together, and basically we talk about computer-integrated manufacturing, where everything is fully automated. Okay? So that's the end of your chapter 1.
Okay, so the benefits of the information system are those five that was the first five that we did, which is the acquisition process,
okay.
Storage, retrieval, presentation.
Those are your five information functions.
Okay, so that is that.
The five components are page 9. The people, task, information, organization, environment. And it's a short summary of the benefits of information systems at section 1.3.2, which is page 11. So basically, as I'm calling out the sections, what you should do is just take a pen and then ask yourself, just mark it, right? Because obviously the stuff that I'm talking about, it's being assessed. The stuff that I'm not talking about is not that important. Okay?
Right. Okay, we're ready for chapter 2.
Are we ready
for chapter 2? Not for the Van Tarten and not for the Zocco,
should say. Right, so we're on page 17. Page 17, okie dokie. So now we're going to talk about, on page 17, as Trevor Noah put it, we're going to be talking about a manager. Okay?
Manager.
So,
manager.
Here's the issue with managers. So managers do many different things, isn't it? Some of you guys are managers, so you'll be aware of this. There's many different categories to a manager. And what chapter 2 really is about, basically I'm just giving an overview of this, is this, and you need to remember this, your chapter 1, 2, 3, right up to your chapter 9, it culminates in chapter 10, okay? In chapter 10, we're talking about this one huge system. What we're trying to do from chapter 1 to 9 is basically, we're breaking this down into different components, okay? So in chapter 2, for example, there's a lot of terminology. So whether I'm talking about an expert system, decision support system, whatever it is I'm talking about, technically, you can see at the end of chapter 2, literally this is basically one system with different aspects around it, okay? So, let's talk about the manager. What does the manager do? Well, basically, from a management point of view, the manager needs to be able to plan, lead, organize, and control things, isn't it? And you do it at different levels of the organization. So that whole paragraph, we're only talking about planning, leading, organizing, and controlling, okay? More importantly, on page 18, and this is where an IT system sort of comes in, is what sort of decisions does the manager make? And there's three categories of information decision making. So the first one is the structured decision making. And the structured decision making is relatively easy, isn't it? If you knew that you were going to order 100 units of something last month, then this month you know you're going to order another 100 units, isn't it? That's structured, you don't need to think about it. Then we talk about semi-structured decision making, but there's a little bit of uncertainty here. So with semi-structured decision making, so for example, we nearing Christmas time, should I make my staff work overtime? That's a bit uncertain because you're not really sure how that is going to work out for you. And lastly, there's unstructured. So unstructured decision making, you really have no idea. You have no solid data on the outcome of your decision. Okay? So for example, entering a new country, you could have all this data around you, but you're not sure that that is going to work. A very famous example of an unstructured decision making process was Nestle decided to sell Nescafe in Nigeria. This happened about 4 to 6 years ago. When they entered the market, it looked great because Nigeria is the most populous country on the African continent. Makes sense, isn't it? We should go there. We've got a good target market. Problem was, Nigerians, nobody drank coffee. Okay? So 3 months, all the stock is sitting there, no moving. So guess what they had to do eventually? They had to hire singers to go to Nigerian villages, literally sing about the merits of Nescafe, and convert people towards drinking coffee. You understand? Okay? That was a typical unstructured decision. We have all this data, but data sometimes doesn't relate to what's actually happening.
But then they didn't do a proper market survey.
It wasn't.
That many people must drink as much coffee. Yeah.
If you looked at it, this is the thing. If you did a proper statistical, like, this is coming in statistics. Statistics could tell you 80% of somebody, 80% of a population is interested in the product. But it doesn't tell you that there's a guarantee they're going to buy it.
No.
Right? So you need to transfer it.